Hello everyone and welcome to a World of Tanks game with me, Mr. Schoolgirls. And this time I'm on my own in my ISU, and as you can see the gun on it, I now have the BL-10 on this ISU, the troll cannon. And oh dear god, is it a troll cannon. And this is the first ever match I had with the troll cannon. Pretty good matchmaking really. And I really wanted to see what I could do with this thing in this match. So this is what happened to first match. We'll get started. There we go, and T50 on their side at the start, literally as soon as we loaded in, did start by saying "got retards," which probably means he's using XVM and can see that most of his team are retards, which isn't good for him, but good for us clearly. And we got a Super Pershing charging down the middle. I'm not sure if that's the best strategy. And I always go here. Always. Only got 18 shells. I don't think I had enough money after switching guns for this thing. Because you think, oh dear, it's T-43 just got hammerwrecked. Poor guy. They were really aggressive down here. And then they seem to have the team syndrome where most of them sit there. And I was scared of the S-51 in this match. But there we see the first one, the VK-2801. And I'm not sure what he thinks he's doing, but he's dead now. So that was my first ever shot with the BL-10, killing a VK in one shot. She's only 610 health. This gun is easily capable. And I'm hiding here from artillery because I think he's probably going to be over there, sat in base. And as you can see, this gun has ridiculous penetration. 286 and 750 damage, which is absolutely phenomenal for tier 8. But you still get the stupid miracle things that, you know, you don't expect to happen, but happen. Like bounces off Jagdpanthers in my other game that I haven't got prepared, but this other game, it was on Malinovka, and he came down the hill and stopped right in the middle down the hill. This Jagdpanther, and it bounced off the gun. Almost 300 pen, it bounced off the gun. And this T-32, I'm pretty sure he's not seen me. But he doesn't want to come out from that building. Or does he? And there goes most of his health. And that's a below average damage roll for this gun. It is a phenomenal, it's such a fun tank. Phenomenal tank. I can't wait for the object, because that just looks like a beast as well. T-21's gone behind, but I want to get the kill. And of course I track him. And the Jag Tiger gets him. Fun. I love it when that happens. But really, if you're running a premium account, if your team loses and you've got two hits in the enemy, you've pretty much made money, even if you die. Two hits of damage is usually enough to make at least something. Non-premium, I'm not sure. I'm really not. But I shouldn't have moved from my spot, because I did have spots on them. Where I could see that Jag Tiger. Now I can't. There's our Jag Tiger. He starts complaining. But of course he does. I'm not sure what to do here. I kind of want to wait for backup. There's only me and a 30 over here. Now I see this IS-3. I'm thinking, is he going to peek round? He is. Such a lucky shot. Such a huge shot as well. 730. Still below average damage. This gun can do over 900 damage in a shot, but I think the lowest it can do is about 630, something like that. Excuse me. So I'm just kind of waiting. I'm thinking to myself, as my first match, I've got to like relax so I can get a taste for the gun. And here's a T-34. He's about to have a very bad day. Almost half his health in a shot. And this gun with my crew, 100% crew, on repairs. And a rammer, I think it's about 15 seconds. Yeah, I'm pretty sure it's about 15 seconds. And that Jagdpanther and the T-54 are just pummeling our Jag Tiger now. And it'll start calling for help and everything, but who can help him? I mean, it'll take me too long to get over there. I mean, I know I'm quite speedy in a straight line, but still, I can't really do anything. He should have backed off down that hill, really, rather than sitting there to take more shots. That shot misses, so I think, fuck it. I've used this position to the most now. Hopefully that 30 will back me up. Oh, Yak Tiger's about to die and start complaining, of course. Now, this is a scary moment, because I know he's reloaded, because he stops. Straight through a Yak Tiger. Dear hey, Yak Tiger's calling everyone noobs. Sure, he got 4 kills, but there's only 2 tier 9s in the game. So, sure. Now, I've got the result screens for this, and there's a T-54 E1, and I'm thinking, oh, good. So the Ferdy comes to my rescue then, because I wouldn't have got that shot and I would have been hammered, probably. So I see a T-34, he's on 4 kills, so he's probably pretty good. And I've just remembered the end of this match, and I'm like a total retard. You'll see. But yeah, I'm thinking, I'll rush down and kill him. He's only got 89 health. What of it? It'll be surely worth it. And the Ferdinand kills him, just by going from there to there. And I come all the way down here. So I think, I might as well just roll with it now. And go up base, because people usually hide behind this hill and snipe. Sometimes too many behind that hill. They look a bit like Muppets then. And half the team sat there. Well, you're about to see how much of a Muppet I am. Most powerful gun in the game left. Probably more powerful than the GW Panther, really. There's a Super Persian, I think. I want to get closer. Oh, no, I don't. What am I doing? He gets through. I do not. So that's one shot he's bounced from BL-10. I don't know about you, but my Super Pershing does not bounce BL-10 shots. It just doesn't. So here we go. My folly. I should have loaded HE. I'm so... This is my, like, biggest weakness and noob thing in the game. Is I am so bad at attacking Super Pershings. They troll me to hell. And that was lucky. And here comes the embarrassment. He's just gonna shoot my tracks, I think. Oh, screw it, I'll just go up and get him in sideways. I'm tracked, and bounce. And I'm pretty sure that hit the far coil there. And now he's tracking me in both sides. I don't know why he doesn't go around me, to be honest. I do have a repair kit as well, so I'm trying to bait him. I don't want to shoot his track. That was just terrible, terrible shot, and everyone on the team will be thinking, what the hell is he doing? So I know what he's going to do, and then he stops. So I've got a sideways shot, bounces on the mantle. Is he going to get around me? I'm wiggling. No. I see what he's doing. No, it's too late. But yeah, I'm so bad at killing Super Pershings. So bad. So thank you all for watching, and I hope you'll join me next time when we may have some more ISU action, seeing as it's so good. Bye.